morning, everyone. I'm Disha-Epseeta, and this is my co-presenter, Disha-Epseeta, from MKCG Medical College, Pisa. And we will be presenting a quick case of a very uncommon lung condition that is advanced. So in this case, the patient is a 25-year-old female named Ms. Sonekanti Kanhar, unmarried, a student by profession residing in the Fulbani region of Kanpa district of Pisa. She arrived at the hospital with a chief complaints of generalized fatigue rashes all over the body, easy fatigability, shortness of breath for the last 1 month, and gum bleeding for the past 15 days. History of breath illness. Patient was apparently alright 1 month back. To start with, she noticed fatigue rashes all over her trunk, which gradually spread over to other parts of the body over a period of 30 days. She also had easy fatigability, myalgia, and dyspnea on exertion, and complained of gum bleeding and hemorrhagia for the past 15 days. There was no history of hematuria, hemodialysis, melena, sternal tenderness, or arthritis, or altered sex hormone in the patient. We did not find or record any history of past illness in the patient or any similar illness in the family members of the patient. Menstrual history, the patient noticed that there was an increased amount and duration of bleeding since the last 30 days. The menses were regular, but were increased from 4 to 8 days per 30-day cycle, associated with no pain and passage of blood. On general examination, we found that the patient is conscious, oriented and unfebrile, vitals are normal, severe pyrex present with petechial rashes which are red, flat, non-branching and present all over the body but more widely distributed over the lower limbs and sacral areas and a few areas having non-palpable purpuric lesions. On systemic examination, all the parameters were found normal. So a provisional diagnosis of immune thrombocytopenic purpura or ITP was made. And the various differential diagnoses that were reached were systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE, hemolytic uremic syndrome, and TTP. For the workup, the investigations that were followed were first of all a CBC, which gave us a result of 5.9 gram per cent of hemoglobin, quite lower than the normal levels. A very significantly reduced platelet count of 4,000 per microliter, and reticulocyte count increased to 10%. The most important part of the investigation, a peripheral smear. The RBC series showed us a picture of normal chromatin hypochromic RBCs, moderate to marked in an isopopular cytosis, macrocytes, raised polychromasia, target cells, teardrop cells, and normal blasts of 20 per 100 RBCs. The WBC series showed us a picture of neutrophilic leukocytosis, and platelets were significantly reduced, all of which was suggestive of hemolytic anemia along with thrombocytopenia. Also, the bone marrow aspiration cytology gave us a picture of hypocellular bone marrow with accelerated erythropoiesis with no evidence of metastasis or leukemia. The most significant or important positive finding in the investigation that led us to the final diagnosis was the direct Coombs test positive for IgG plus C3b and an elevated level of serum LDH, which was 1465 units per liter. The tests for anti-nuclear antibodies and anti-double-stranded DNA were negative, ruling out the possibilities of SLE. And therefore, the final diagnosis was reached as Marfan syndrome, which is the presence of simultaneous or sequential autoimmune hemolytic anemia plus immune thrombocytopenic purpura. The condition was accordingly treated with the first line of treatment. The most preferred first line of treatment is usually corticosteroid therapy. As such, injection of methylprednisolone, injection of ceftriaxone, and iron folic acid tablets were administered to the patient. On follow-up, we found that the patient has successfully responded to the corticosteroid therapy of prednisolone 40 as her CBC was almost normal and petechial rashes had disappeared within 1 month. So therefore, the condition that we discussed about is Marfan syndrome, which is basically the presence of simultaneous or sequential direct Coombs positive autoimmune hemolytic anemia in conjunction with immune-mediated thrombocytopenia with no underlying etiology. And most importantly, this is a diagnosis of exclusion. That's all. Thank you for your patience. Treatment is usually corticosteroid therapy, and the most preferred is prednisolone as a corticosteroid. But if it is a case of resistant Marfan syndrome, there are various types of Marfan syndrome. There is primary Marfan syndrome, secondary Marfan syndrome, resistant Marfan syndrome. So if the corticosteroid therapy does not work, patient comes to follow up after 3 months and it does not work, then we switch to some other immunomodulators that we can administer, like sirolimus, azathioprine, mycophenolate, mofetil, and cyclosporine. And if that does not work, we can go for stem cell transplant, autologous or stem cell transplantations. Clinical is done in few cases, but there is no reliable statistics that it is actually helpful. It is usually done if there is a high risk of sepsis or the patient is not responding to any other treatment, or there are frequent relapses or remissions of